Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
We are still trying to figure out how we got a goose egg yesterday in Tampa at that football game.
Yeah.
9-0, right? I think it was 9-0.
Yeah, pretty intense. I mean, and you know what's funny is that when they were coming in at the half, I was looking and I was trying to figure out why. I saw some of the, you know, the Bucks' faces, and they were concerned. I'm saying, why are you concerned, man? I says, you got a whole nother half. Because that's very unusual. I mean, it was a low score. It was only 7-0, you know, at the half. But guess
except,
what?
Except it was the Saints, and they haven't beat the Saints at home for years.
Oh, that's interesting. Wow.
Yes. I think they have not. I think it's been at least 4 years. I could be wrong on
that's
that.
Crazy.
But it's been a while.
Yeah.
So you know, when you're down at the half and you're like, it's just the jinx, you know.
That's playing. That plays out, man. That plays out. There's no doubt.
And only people, I think only people from Boston believe in jinxes, don't they?
I don't know. I think if you play a lot of sports, you do. Well, but I know what you're saying from the Red Sox. But I really do. Do you know what I mean? Because it's like, okay, you know how your head goes, man. You know that whatever you bring about, you think about. Yeah. You know that's real, man. I mean, if you start worrying too much, you're done, man.
Yeah. Well, that's why golfers, they have this routine. They call them routines. You know, before you hit the ball, and you kind of go through this little checklist. So they're also superstitious. I mean, it's good to get you into the mindset of everything.
Right.
But you know, some of it's. But I decided yesterday, after watching Charlie Woods, Tiger's son, playing that father's son, that I'm going to give up the game of golf. I could not beat him.
Was it cool? I know. I know he's 2-under. Did he come in second? I know Daly came in.
They came in tied for second, which is pretty amazing.
Okay.
But the shots that little Charlie was hitting. So there was a number 17 out at that course is a par 3, and it's about 170 yards, give or take.
Okay.
And yesterday they had every single person teeing off from the exact same set of tees. So it didn't matter whether you were 12 years old or you were 82, like Gary Player.
Okay.
Or maybe that's Lee Trevino's 82. I think Gary might be 86. So everybody from the same set of tees. And Charlie was the one that was closest to the pin. Of all of those players.
Wow.
All those majors.
Amazing.
Yeah, that's what I decided.
And he's 12, right?
And he's 12, yeah. He's 12. So
that's
I'm
intense.
Like, okay.
That's intense.
Time for me to look for a new sport out there. But, you know, the question on people's minds
is,
Exactly. Are we going to get a Santa Claus rally? Is one about to begin? Of course, listening to your overview of the spies and the Qs and so forth, one might be able to answer that yes. But for me, the Santa Claus really begins with the fall bottom. This is that annual seasonal cycle. So the real rally that folks should always be looking for is the one that occurs in the fall, which on average is around October. Now, this year, that fall bottom formed on September 20th, 2021. That didn't give us our bottoming signal there, but that's the low of the cycle. And so the Santa Claus rally has already begun. But what Christmas, you know, what folks want to know is, hey, Steve, Christmas is only 5 days away. So is Santa going to deliver coal or what? And of course, I was listening to you about Kathy Woods out there. You know, she might not want to watch this presentation here.
I she's done well. I mean, even 5 years, she's still up 400% or something. But I don't even get 40% compounded. I mean, that's insane.
Yes. Well, she might want to start that compounding in a couple of years when we form another bottom. But first, if we take a look at the ES Mini and really back to kind of your analysis early on, we can see that daily support is holding. Now, I'm taking a look at the ES Mini. You were talking about the spies and the queues and the volume that's pulling back. Well, here on this chart here, the ES Mini is holding trendline support. It's holding the bottom of its profile. It's holding the weekly support level. That would be the box in the upper right-hand corner. The box in the lower left-hand corner is the top, is the monthly profiles, prices above those. So at this stage here, we should, like you've said, we should see some kind of rally, perhaps through the end of the week, maybe into next week out there. But so, you know, it's not unreasonable to expect that we should see some type of bounce from here. But if the week ends, so we're talking about, I believe Thursday is the end of trading. I think
yes, it is.
Right? Okay.
Yep.
So if this is what folks want to really be paying attention to come Thursday. If at week's end, the SPY closes below 445.23. Now, the SPY is in the upper right-hand corner.
Yeah.
And 445.23 represents the bottom of the weekly profile. If we get that combined with the SMHs, the SMHs are the bottom panel here.
Okay.
If they close below 291.14, then Santa will be delivering coal. And I'll go through the reasons why. Now, this is the weekly time frames that we're looking at.
Yeah.
The SMH is maybe hard to see, but right now price is trading below the bottom of its bullish structured profile. And I like to say there's nothing more bearish than a failed bullish pattern. But this comes weekend. It's not what it's doing right now at 3:24 in the afternoon. But those are the numbers really to be watching on Thursday. And the reason why those are key levels is I just bring this back to the ES Mini. And in the ES Mini, you and I, we've looked at this chart in the past out here. This looks at weekly profiles. I've kind of scrunched a little bit more on the ES side here. But though by the dip points have been the bottom of those weekly profiles. And those are the green arrows out here. So at this stage, at 44.96.50, I mean, you kind of keep using it until it stops working. Right? As long as it works, keep using it. And so that is a key level of support. It just adds, again, to your idea that we should see some kind of bounce here. But if price closes below that, just like it did back in February, that says that we've got a change in trend unfolding. And that's really what we were looking at in this set of charts here before with just looking at the SPYs and the SMHs. Because I know everybody at home who's got charting systems, they can take a look at those levels. They may not have the TAS market profiles, but if they just mark those amounts on or those dollar amounts on there, they'll be able to take a look at it. So the thing is that if we do get that change in trend, we're about to also enter the unfavorable seasonal cycle, which typically takes place, Tom, in early January and lasts through the end of the month. So if we do get that change in trend, that's suggesting to me Santa's delivering coal and we're going to see the markets move down at least through the end of January. But last week, you and I discussed one of the patterns that we use to help us identify tops or bottom is the TD9 count. And the high can come on bars 8 and 9 or the bar following 9. Well, we're in the bar following 9 for the Dow, for the S&P 500, for the Russell 2000, for the Semiconductor Index, for the NASDAQ Composite, and for the New York Stock Exchange. So many of our yearly, these are yearly charts that we're taking a look at, say it is time that we may get some type of rest out here. So we'll want to watch those levels. See, we're about to run out of time here. And the only thing that I can find, Tom, that could get in the way,
okay,
and I don't see it getting in the way right now, is the global flow of capital. And here I take a look at the rate of change for the way that different instruments are trading in terms of dollars, euros, yen, and pounds out here. And your last guest was talking about China. If I take a look at the Shanghai right here where my cursor's at,
yes,
it's all negative at this stage here. Money's not flowing. I'm not seeing the money flowing into China that others are seeing, whether it's the Shanghai or the Hang Seng out there.
I like it. I like it. And folks, it's very easy to get Steve's newsletter. Come over to our website, the TFNN. You're going to go into newsletters. Hit newsletters right on the right-hand side. Steve, ho, 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 Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to your family.
Okay, man. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.